Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, students. Here I am your science teacher from Ismailia Youth Services School. Students, if you remember, in our last class, means yesterday, we have completed the chapter number 5, and today we are going to start the new chapter, that is the heat and energy. But before going to start this chapter, I would like to say you something, that please take your science book along with you and take the screenshot of every slide which will be shared over here. One more thing, that please do not raise your hand during lecture, but ask question at the end of the lecture in chat box only. You have to done your home task in your fair copy of the subject, means in your science fair copy. This chapter, heat and energy, is present in your book as a unit 9 on page number 83. And the topic of this chapter, which will be selected for today's lecture, are heat, conductors and insulator, and methods of heat transfer. Now, move forward. Heat. What is heat? We can say that heat is a degree of temperature. Yes, when in a hot day we feel that today is high temperature, so we said that today is a hot day. But in science, it is not the correct definition of heat. Actually, in scientific term, heat is a type of energy, and it is found in an object that has a higher temperature than its surrounding. Means a body which has high temperature according to its surrounding. So, we can say that in this body, heat is present, or heat energy is present. Actually, the molecule of that object, or we can say when an object is heated, actually its molecules gain energy and start moving faster. As they vibrate, they bump into each other at a faster rate and push the particles in front of them. This movement continues and heat travel from one end to the other end. Actually, students, everything in the world is made up of matter, and we know that matter is made up of tiny particles. These particles of the matter may be the atoms, ions, or molecules. But the main thing about the matter is that these particles are constantly moving. Maybe they move or they vibrate. Actually, this movement is responsible to transfer heat from one end to the other end. As I shared you, when an object is heated, so the one end of the heat, as you observe in the picture, in the metal picture, the tip of rod is at the fire. So this tip receives heat from the fire, and the molecule from here is vibrating, and by receiving the heat energy, their vibration will be faster. And this faster movement is by this faster movement they bump to each other, and this faster movement is continues from one to the another particle, and then this heat energy is transferred from one end to the other end. Right? Okay. As I told you, anything or everything in the world is made up of the matter. Matter has the particles, which may be the ion, atom, or molecules. But the main thing, they vibrate, they move. And this movement is actually responsible to transfer heat. In different materials, or we can say the things which we found on the earth, they have ability to transfer this material. in good quantity or in bad quantity, or they do not conduct or they do not transfer the seed. That's why we categorize them into the conductors and insulators. So some materials like iron, steel, and copper that allow heat to travel through them means the particles inside them, they vibrate and they allow the heat to travel through them quickly. So they are called the good conductor of heat. That's why we use the iron, steel, and copper for conduction of electricity and heat in the form of wires. And some material like rubber, wood, and plastic, they do not allow heat to travel through them easily. That's why they are called bad conductor of heat. But there are some other material like the wool, fur, and feather. They do not conduct heat or electricity in any way. And they are called insulator, means good conductor conduct heat very quickly, bad conductor mostly do not conduct, but sometimes they conduct heat but very slowly, and insulator do not conduct. Here you can observe some pictures and you can categorize that wood is the bad conductor, but the wool or the fur and the feather, they are the insulator, and the copper, silver, aluminium, they are the good conductor. That's why we use some insulator or bad conductor material as for the making of handles of pots and pans. Or we can see the handles of pots and pans are made up of the wood or plastic, so that the heat is not conducted easily and our hand do not burn. Are you getting? I hope you understand. One more thing. There are special dress for the firefighters. Firefighter wear clothes which is made up of insulating materials. Means they have the material which do not, their dress, their clothes have the material which are insulator. And by the insulating material, their dress is called the fiberglass. Or we can say firefighter wear clothes which are made up of the insulating material, and that material is called fiberglass. Yes, one more interesting thing, that air is a good insulator. Insulator means air cannot heat, cannot pass heat easily. Air cannot pass heat. That's why we wear woolen cloths in winter, because inside this can trap the air. And this air keep us warm. We wear woolen cloths in winter to keep warm, because wool traps air between its fiber. You understand? I hope you understand. Actually, the woolen, the sweaters is a stretchable. And during this stretching, the air is trapped in the spaces, and this air keep our body warm. Okay. As I told you, anything is made up of the matter, and they have tiny particles which are constantly moving, and due to this moving, the heat transfer from one end to the other end. And we know that we found the solid matter, the liquid matter, and the gaseous matter. That's why the heat transfer method are also indifferent. And here we are going to share the methods of heat transfer in different material. Different methods are used to transfer heat from one end to the other end. And what are these methods? The conduction, the convection, and radiation. Inshallah, today we will share the conduction and some part of the convection. Firstly, what is conduction? Actually, in conduction, heat can travel through solids, right? heat can travel through solids by conduction. It means that we observe conduction mostly in the solid particles. And how we observe? If one end of a metal spoon is dipped in hot water, as you observe in this picture, as my pointer is moving around the picture, so one end of the metal spoon is dipped in hot water, the other end heats up after a short while. Why? Because the molecule at the dip end gain energy from hot water. They start vibrating and push the molecule in front of them. On gaining energy, these molecules also start vibrating, and a chain reaction is set up by which the other end of the spoon heats up. As you observe in this picture, in the second picture, the rod which is near to the burner, so it is red in color, its molecule receive energy, heat energy. They vibrate faster, and by this vibration they transfer this energy from one end to other end. One more thing, that in conduction every molecule is vibrating, or we can say in conduction heat transfer from molecule to molecule, from atom to atom. Means every molecule is responsible to transfer heat from one end to the other end. I hope you understand. Okay, now here we are going to share an activity. One more interesting thing, or this interesting statement, that water is a bad conductor of heat. Water cannot conduct heat easily. How can we prove that? Okay, there is an activity. If we take a small ice cube, right? Take a small ice cube and wrap it with a piece of gauze. Means covered it with a piece of small cotton cloth. A small piece of ice cube is covered with the cotton cloth and dropped into a test tube. This test tube must be full of water. Why we covered this ice with the gauze or the cotton cloth? Because this gauze or the cotton sink the ice cube. We know that if we put the ice in the water, it will float. But in this activity, we need to sink this ice. That's why we covered it with the gauze or the cotton piece and dropped into a test tube which is full of water. And by this covering, the ice cube will sink. And then we hold the test tube with the test tube holder and put its top part, or put the top part of the test tube close to the Bunsen flame, as you observe in the picture. What will we observe? After a short time, we observe that the area which received the heat, the area of test tube that received the heat inside that test tube, the water will start to boil. But the ice cube which is sitting at the bottom is still in the form of solid. It does not melt. That's why this activity proves that water cannot conduct heat easily. Or this activity is also proved by another way, that if we freeze the test tube with the water, so we have the test tube is full of ice, and we hold it with the test tube holder and put its one end near to the Bunsen burner. So we observe that at that area which receives the heat, the ice will melt and start to boil, but the nearing part or the near part of the ice will not even melt. Why? Because water is the bad conductor of heat. I hope you understand. Yes, the next way is the convection. The next way of heat transfer in material is the convection. And we observe convection in liquid and in air. Convection occurs when heat is transferred from one part of a fluid or liquid to the other part by movement of the fluid itself. as we observe about the conduction, in conduction, the molecules are vibrating and they transfer heat by their vibration. Because in solid, the particles are tightly fixed. Particles are arranged in fixed proportion. But in liquid and gas, the molecule has a space and they strike easily with each other and they move easily. That's why in the liquid and gas, heat transfer by the movement of the fluid particle itself. Right? And we observe this convection in the ventilation of room and heating water in a pan. Right? And we observe that when in liquid and in gas, when molecule is heat up, it moves in upward direction and the cool molecule quickly move in the downward direction as you observe in the picture. Here is a picture of AC which produces the cool air. This cool air quickly moves to the downward and in the room where the hot air is present, it moves quickly in the upward direction. That's why they make a swirl or the circle. Also, we observe in water, when we heat up the water or any liquid, they move in the circle form. The hot water moves upward and at the top, the molecules of water which become cold, they quickly move to the downward position. That's why they make the circle or they move in this direction. And we prove this this movement of the molecule by an activity. And the activity name is the convection in liquid. We mostly observe it in the labs. What will we do? Actually, we fill a beaker. We fill a beaker with tap water and drop a large crystal of potassium permanganate. The color of potassium permanganate is pink or purplish, right? What we have to do? We take a beaker, fill it with tap water and put a large crystal of potassium permanganate in it. Then we we heat this beaker by putting on the stand and apply it or the supply to the heat. What will we observe? We observe an upward current of colored water. The potassium permanganate, which is present at the bottom of the beaker, they start to melt, but the colored water is moving upward direction. And it moves and spread it outward. Then it will move to the down. Right? This is called the convection current. This movement move from downward to upward and spread at the top, then move downward. This circle is called the convection current. Easily observed by this activity. As you observe another picture, the color of potassium permanganate is spread firstly from down to the upward, then is spread at the top, and then they start to move in the downward condition. This movement of molecule is called the convection in liquid. Yes, but before going to home task, we conclude what we learned today. We learn heat. What is heat? Mostly we said heat is a degree of temperature, but scientifically heat is a form of energy. And heat is found in an object that has high temperature. And heat can transfer from one end to the other end by the movement of molecules of the object. As they receive heat, the molecule of the object move faster and they transfer heat by their movement from one end to the other end. And we observe heat mostly in the fire, in the sun. The main source of the heat is the sun, is the fire. And actually our earth receives the heat mainly from the sun. And when we burn the fossil fuels, that's why these are the two main areas where we receive the heat. Now, some materials conduct heat quickly, so they are called the good conductor. Some materials cannot conduct heat quickly. They are termed as the bad conductor. And some do not conduct heat in any way. That's why they are called insulator. And we learned that copper, iron, aluminium, silver, all these are the good conductor of heat. That's why the metallic rod are also commonly used to transfer heat. And the rubber, the wood, the plastic, they are the bad conductor. They cannot conduct heat easily. While the wool, the fur, and the feather, they are the insulator. They cannot conduct heat anyway. That's why we use bad conductors or the insulators for making insulating things. Just like the handle of pots and pans are made up of the wood or the plastic, hard plastic. So heat cannot conduct it from the pan to the handles, and our hand will not burn. Similarly, the people who are used to, who are doing the job of as a firefighter, so they have to wear special dresses, and their dress are made up of the insulating material, which is called the fiberglass. We also learned that air is a good insulator, and air is trapped in the woolen cloths. And that's why when we wear the woolen cloths in winter, our body keep warm because air trap our body's temperature inside the sweaters or the warm cloths. Then we also learn that heat can be transferred in three methods, that is the conduction, convection, radiation. Conduction is observed mostly in solid. Or we can say heat travels through solid by conduction. Mostly it is observed in the good conductor of heat. And we also learned that conduction is done by particle to particle. Every molecule is involved for the conduction of heat in solid. And conductivity is the ability of material to conduct heat. Some solid material conduct good amount of heat. Some have ability to conduct little amount of heat. So the conductivity is the ability of material to conduct heat. Okay, what is conductivity? It is the ability of any material or the matter that how much amount of heat the material can be conduct. And we learned that metals are the good conductor of heat. We also learn an activity. And we prove that water is a bad conductor of heat. In this activity, we wrap or cover a piece of ice with a gauze to sink it in the test tube. We hold the test tube and its top part put close to the Bunsen flame. We observe that when the flame continuously warms the water at the top of the test tube, even the water starts to boil. But the ice at the bottom of the tube does not melt because water is the bad conductor of heat. Another way of heat transfer is the convection. Convection is occur in liquid and gas. When heat transfer from one part of fluid to the another by the movement of fluid, as I told you, in liquid and gas, the particles have space to move freely. That's why they move in this. Not all the particles are involved to transfer heat. That's why liquid transfer heat a little bit slowly. We observe it, the convection in the ventilation of room, and we also observe it heating of water in fan. We observe the process of convection, the movement of their molecules of fluid by an activity. In this activity, we have to fill a beaker with water and put in the water a crystal of potassium permanganate. The color of potassium permanganate is purplish pink. When start to heat the beaker. When we heat the beaker, we will observe that when the potassium permanganate start to melt, the upward current of colored water, actually color is the potassium permanganate. So the upward current of colored water will rise and spread outward. It will then move down the sides of beaker, showing that the convection current has been set up, and they move in a circle, and they move in a circle as we observe in the convection in the room or boiling water. It is all about the learning. Now come to the home task. Our today's home task is to differentiate between conductors and insulators with four examples each. Means you have to define the conductors, give its example, good conductors and bad conductors. Then you have to give the example of the good conductor and bad conductor. Then give heading of the insulator, define the insulator and give its example. Then describe conduction. What is conduction? You have to describe it in one paragraph. And define convection, give two examples. Okay, you can write the answer of these only three questions from your book or also from with the help of these slides. It's up to you. In your book, the answer of conductor insulator is present on page number 84. And as the question described conduction in one paragraph, it is also present in your book on page number 84 under the heading of the conduction. And define convection, give two examples. This, the answer of this question is present in your book on page 85 under the heading of convection. Or you can also write the answer from the slides that I shared today. I hope you understand what today's lecture. It's all about today's learning. Thank you.